What do I think about the Monday night football game on ESPN between the Tampa Bay Buccaneers and the Carolina Panthers in a NFC South division for sole possession of first place? It was fantastic. It was phenomenal. The fans showed up to show their appreciation. And Carolina Panthers won it more than Tampa Bay did, 38-23, and show these critics slash naysayers, experts, so-called experts, sports columnists, sports writers, that the Carolina Panthers are a team to be forced to reckon with. If you think otherwise, go ahead, disagree with me. Constructive criticism is always welcome, but no flaming hating comments, please, or I will delete your comments and block you. I can give you three reasons why the Carolina Panthers won that game. First off is the offensive line. They did one heck of a job of pushing the Tampa Bay Buccaneers defense out of the way. I mean, they basically beat them like a stepchild. Number two, the running backs just ran circles around the D, up and down, east, west, I mean, any way you want to put it. I mean, Rondae Barber, who is a twin brother of Tiki Barber, just straight up got owned big time by Smash and Dash. If you see the replays, you will know what I'm talking about. D'Angelo Williams having 19 rushing attempts for 186 yards for two touchdowns, and Jonathan Stewart with 15 rushing attempts for 115 yards and two touchdowns. Wow, that is just unbelievable. And number three, the defense. They sacked Jeff Garcia five times. Julius Peppers had one heck of a game, being destructive. To the offense for the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, he ended up getting 1.5 sacks. Down to the Julius Peppers haters, where are you now? Just a year ago, you were ready to write him off as he's a bust, he's a loser, he's this, he's that. Yeah, he had a disappointing year. He didn't use any injuries as an excuse. He just played a bad year. A real football player, a real athlete takes guts to say that type of stuff. The least you can do is give him props. Now, here's what I'm worried about. Two things. One is the pass defense. How can you give up 321 yards to Jeff Garcia, who went 24-38 passing attempts and completions and such? I mean, he was like Michael Vick, but moving around the pocket, making defenders miss a little bit. But he can throw a better accuracy than Michael Vick. Number two, Jake DeLone taking a gunsling-like mentality. Chances, I mean, it scares me as a fan. It's like, when is he going to realize that doing that type of crap is going to get this team into a hot water? That they're going to end up playing catch-up. I mean, they can't afford to be doing that on the Sunday Night Football on NBC in 2 weeks against the New York Football Giants. So, I give you a couple reasons why the Tampa Bay Buccaneers lost that game. One, the Buccaneers defense got annihilated and humiliated all in the same night. Monty Kiffin is going to be just beside himself that he watched his defense completely got shredded. And like I said, Rondae Barber got owned. Number two, you're not going to win games if Jeff Garcia is laying on his back five times. Or should I say getting sacked five times. I mean, you got Antonio Bryant resurrecting his career, and that's all good with 9 catches for 200 yards. That goes for Steve Smith. For the Carolina Panthers, they did good too with nine catches. First 117 yards. So, yeah. And Musa Muhammad did his thing too, even though he didn't do as much with 3 catches and 43 yards. Yeah. This week, this Sunday, they got at home again for their final home game against the Denver Broncos, while the Tampa Bay Buccaneers go to Atlanta. So it'll be very interesting to see how Carolina Panthers play against the Denver Broncos. If they can keep Jay Cutler under control, everything's all good. All the Carolina Panthers offense have to do is just continue the way they done against the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. This time they're facing the Denver Broncos. They're not a threat, but don't underestimate them. They will surprise you in any way, shape, or form. If I'm a Carolina Panthers, that's all I got. Leave a comment if you wish. Constructive criticism is always welcome. Carolina, Tampa Bay fans, football fans, let me hear it from you. SA17, see ya.